But it's very important for him to use that influence to help usher in this new age of man, this new age of consciousness that is springing to life around Delta Soul. This planet is coming to life on a conscious level that has not been seen since I've been here. And I've been here quite a while. Now, I don't know if it's happened yet, but the Catholic Church will start to warm up to the idea that there are quote-unquote extraterrestrial beings, and that this is all part of God's plan, they can say. And Yeshua right now is assisting them in bringing this knowledge out, because he wants to make sure their influence is used for good. And a great many people in religions around the world, I can say this with some level of confidence, are good people. There's typically not a lot of money in religion. Well, not in America. In America, there seems to be an inordinate amount of money associated with religion. But in many places around the world, taking on a life of poverty is kind of inherent into serious involvement in one's faith. And those people, for the most part, I've found, do it for the right reasons. Now, the reasons may differ, but the end goal that they see is the same. People living in harmony and peace with one another around the planet. And that's what has to take place in the next 2 years. Before December 21st, 2012, a great many things need to happen on this planet. But one of them is that these small, petty disagreements that cause so much destruction on your planet have to cease. Now, there's different ways, I guess, I could go about instructing people on how to do this, but this has to be your choice. This has to be your leaders' respective choices to quell these disagreements and stop the bloodshed. Because the species that are watching your planet are going to make a decision based on how you conduct yourselves as a collective over the next 2 years, as to whether or not you will actually be able to have a say into the process through which you ascended into the galactic community. This is very important information. It would be very important for you to pay attention when these leaders begin to tell you to leave low-lying areas. You'll want to try to be at least 300 miles inland. And probably they will say 1,000 kilometers above sea level. It may not be 300 miles inland. The geography of the Earth obviously varies from place to place. The threats, the potential threats that exist right now on Earth vary from place to place. One that's been studied is because it would affect the eastern seaboard of the United States, is an island off the coast of Africa, whose northwest-facing side is potentially sliding off into the Atlantic, that would create a large tidal wave tsunami that could devastate the east coast of America. Now, as the Earth over the next couple of years begins to go through these upheavals, leaders are going to begin to instruct individuals to, for their own safety, go to higher ground. You're going to hear this a lot over the next 2 years, the phrase higher ground. Stevie Wonder, a very good friend of mine, should cash in on that. I don't say that jokingly. Stevie Wonder is a very unique individual. If you've ever met him, you will know exactly what I mean by this next statement. You can feel his joy, the phrase infectious joy, matches him to a T. He's been through so much, and his soul is so strong and so powerful, and he's had such a positive effect on so many people. He's an amazing individual. But let's get back to the true history of America. The Lemurians had established themselves for the most part. They had consolidated their power into Europe. This was done for a variety of reasons. Most importantly was that they had a very difficult time trading with certain areas of the globe throughout history. One that comes to mind right away is the Middle East. The Middle East, the Persian Empire, was very difficult for them to trade with, and they were blocking the Silk Routes into China. Now, the Lemurians could go around these land-based routes, just took a lot longer. They knew that you couldn't sail from Europe around the globe and end up in the Far East. They knew that, you know, no Panama Canal existed at that time. I guess I shouldn't joke about something like that. The Panama Canal is, as someone who's been through there on several different occasions, it's a feat of engineering. I'll give your species that. But you have cut a whole landmass off from the other side. A great many species, their natural evolutions have been disrupted. It's one of the prime examples of the human race meddling in something of which they don't know enough yet to meddle. The Three Gorges Dam that I talked about earlier is another prime example of this ignorance. They say the road to hell is paved with good intentions. There's been a lot of good intentions throughout the history of your people that have ended up with catastrophic consequences that, in retrospect, those who put these things into place said they could not have predicted. As someone who has known some of these individuals, I can say with confidence that they did indeed predict. They knew that that was a possibility, yet they did it anyway. And that's a lot what's going on today. Right now, on this planet, there's a lot of gambling going on with your leaders. A lot of, they call it bluffing, I believe, where you pretend you have a stronger hand in cards than you do. This is happening with Hugo Chavez in Venezuela, because Venezuela right now is prime real estate. Anything near the equator right now, over the next few years, is going to become much more prime real estate. There's a country in the Middle East, Dubai, where they've built these silly sand islands out in the Gulf. I think they're trying to make it look like a tree or a globe or something. These are just going to be absorbed back into the sea. These individuals have wasted their money, and their children's children will be penniless because of that, because the resources that they sell, crude oil, fossil fuels, are running out very quickly for your people. And alternative energy sources are right now being researched all around the planet, but at CERN, where LOCARE is, where I have been recently on a couple of occasions, I can tell you that the powers that be on your planet are very interested in finding alternatives to fossil fuels. This kind of coincides, or dovetails, if you will, with their other plan, which is some sort of culling of the population. But let's get back to the history of America, because I look at the tape and it looks like it's about halfway through. I wonder what Maxell is. All the tapes that I have say Maxell on them. These individuals that had established themselves mainly in Europe became very aware as the 15th and 16th centuries passed, that they were becoming unwelcome in these kingdoms. They had grown very powerful. They had grown very rich. Their wars had been more successful at times than that of their formal host, the king, emperor, whatever the title respectively would have been in that kingdom. Their power grew because they had become aware long ago of a secret that was being kept in Jerusalem, in the Temple of David, in what they called the Holy of Holies. Some very ancient texts that were information that was passed down between the 4th and 5th ages. And this information was said to contain everything from the cycles of the galactic cycles that brought about these changes and when they would be coming again, down to alchemy and things like metallurgy, controlling basic elements in ways that even now, today, with modern technology, are just now being touched upon by your scientists. They had, through the Crusades, battled against various other powerful organizations to try to obtain these ancient texts. The Knights Templar, the actual lineage of the British royal crown is connected to the Lemurians. The Lemurians loved the kingdom or the island of Great Britain. And it is said that the reason that society was able to retain its culture and not be wiped out by the Roman Empire was because it had holed away in northern Scotland, where even today there exists a very core community of these individuals, who these families, these small groups, have lived in these same castles. They're actual castles for centuries. Now, these individuals very much were interested in this new world that now is called America. They knew it existed, but the Spaniards had begun sending conquistadors to the New World and had begun coming back with large amounts of gold. And that drew everyone on Earth's attention immediately to Spain. And it drew everyone's attention to the New World. Now, the Lemurians knew that this gold existed there. They had obtained vast quantities of it over the centuries. But they also knew that these people were very difficult to negotiate with in traditional trade. The Spaniards' answer to that was one of a vicarious nature. They arrived and spread disease through these populations, for the most part unintentionally, but there are several accounts of them passing along blankets or food that was poisoned, blankets that they were known to have been infected with some contagious disease. The Lemurians in Northern Europe very much disliked the way the Spaniards were handling this, and they decided to dispatch their own scout parties to North America. Now, the Nordic kingdoms had been visiting North America, Greenland and North America, for about 1,000 years, and they had set up colonies there. The Lemurians in Northern Europe were trading with these colonies. They were part of the supply network. They sent individuals to begin civilization in North America, to begin conducting trade with the native North Americans that existed there at the time. This got out of hand for them very quickly, however, because during that time in Europe, there was a lot of what they referred to, the term now would be religious persecution. People, different faiths were springing up. It seemed like almost a new one every week was springing up in Europe. And a lot of fundamentalist, kind of extreme fringe teachings were being taught. And these individuals were very much seeking a place to begin anew and develop their own society where they could practice their religions the way they wanted. The Lemurians, who had established this colony in North America, decided that this would be a good cover story to bring this power construct across the Atlantic. It would be that way because they were able to draw a vast quantity of a large workforce. These people don't have large families. They're not huge organizations. They can't function on their own. They're not necessarily lazy, but they've lived very comfortable lifestyles. They would much rather have other people do the hard work for them. And there's a limitless supply on your planet. Because so many people are born into poverty, they don't know how to be successful in life. They don't know. They've got nothing else to go on. They strive for simple things, simple sustenance. And as they are given more and more by human nature, they crave more and more. And the Lemurians understand this very well. And as this new continent was beginning to be populated with these Caucasians from Europe,